Sam Martin set to kick off.
And we are underway from SoFi Stadium. Taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Jacobs. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
Jacobs, the ball carrier.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down.
Back at the 37-yard line.
Cousins to throw it this time. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. They'll indeed go for it. It's Cousins. It's intercepted. Picked up by Carl Joseph. It's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
So after the INT, here's Wentz. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. First down for the Bears, a gain of 15.
First down, Chicago. Snap coming at one. Now Wentz. And it is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they'll get this down to the 10. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. First and goal. A chance to convert that early turnover into points. Throwing is Wentz. They'll run the screen with Carson. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Chris Carson, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bears have taken the early lead. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25.
I can't help it. Every time I see Eric Berry make a play, as we just saw him make a tackle there, I just want to stand up and applaud.
Because he went to Tennessee like you?
Well, that doesn't hurt one bit, but how about the comeback? I mean, he came back from beating cancer and getting back to Pro Bowl level, one of the best players in the game.
On second down, Jacobs. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to...
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
To throw, Cousins. And this is going to be incomplete.
Looks like a second empty possession to start the game, and certainly not the way you want to start when you're coming off of a loss last week. Every team talks about starting fast. They're hoping on their next possession, it can be a delayed fast start and get them going.
Now remember, they were unsuccessful earlier in this first quarter. Going for it on fourth, they're going to try a second time. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. The conversion is successful with a sizable gain of 13, and the decision to go for it looks like a smart one. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Running is Jacobs. He's got a first down inside the midfield. And brought down across the 50 to the 49-yard line. 11 more yards that go around. A first down as well. Now Cousins. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. The first down screen pass, good for five.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. First carry now for the Memphis man, Darrell Henderson. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43. 5 yards on first down, but now just a one-yard pickup there on second.
Third and four.
Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Working out of the gun, Cousins escaping the pressure right. And that is incomplete. Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt, that in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. From the gun, here's Cousins. Open man is Westbrook complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That pickup goes for 25. What a flip of the script. From fourth down to first. To the running game with Jacobs. That stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll look to run with Henderson, and this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the three. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Bears 7, Rams nothing.
They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. They'll run it with Jacobs. And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. Josh Jacobs with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
Ties the game at 7. Pat O'Donnell set to kick off.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
First and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Offense ready to go for their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back.
And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Off the edge, Jerry Hughes gets the sack.
A loss of 11 yards.
Another try after the first down sack. Wentz. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
A pickup of 15 yards.
Now Wentz on third down. Off to Thomas on the left side. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. First target, first catch, and a first down. Shotgun now for Wentz. That's complete into the hands of Carson. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. The Bears on the move. They've got another first down.
The Bears first down.
It's Wentz. Caught on the right side by Adams.
Wentz is
that one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
It's second and inches at the Rams' 34-yard line.
I think this is against the Bears here. Let's find out. And that'll set them back five. Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. Again, it's Wentz. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
But they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
First down, Wentz. Now they go screen, it's complete. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
This is the Oklahoma State man, Chris Carson. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go.
And it's third down.
He's got Adams on the hookup. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. to throw. It's Wentz. Screen. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Not much there, only a yard.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner. Everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short gain.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's 7. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now. We'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action.
On second and goal, here's the option.
And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. He'll wind up getting 3 on the keeper there, but it leads to a 3rd down. Try and run the option to pick it up. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. It's their quarterback. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Bears have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Fix the score, Bears 14, Rams 7. Sam Martin set to kick.
So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. Bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Now the Bears going to use the 2nd of their timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And find Henderson there. It's complete. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. First play of the drive going for 14 and a 1st down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On 1st and 10, Cousins. That's taken in by Henderson. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Consecutive catches for him. That good for 11.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice 1st down. Drive keeps moving.
Cousins now from the 50. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. The Rams going to go ahead and use the 1st of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number 1. And incomplete.
They've given up a few 1st downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
I don't want to seem absurd when that boy's a gangster. Focusing
Second and 10 now from the 27.
He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet.
Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. And he gets the first down yards before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. Week 7 action, and we've got a 7-point game here in the second quarter. And this offense hoping to change that right here. Steps away to his left. He's going to keep it again. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. Give him 6 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. Cousins gets this one out wide quickly. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. D.D. Westbrook, as the first half is winding down. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot.
And that's caught inside the 35. And all the way inside the 35 before he goes out of bounds.
First down.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. It'll be a 49-yard attempt from the left hash. Seibert's kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we've hit halftime. Just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, set to resume. Here we go in the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll
a couple extra yards here for his trouble of bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27.
At their own 27-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now Wentz. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. 7 yards there on the first down screen play.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Throwing again on second down. Wentz. And they set up the screen. That's complete. They'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
On third down. Carson, and he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
First down, Chicago.
Midfield. Here's Wentz. And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Geno Atkins forced his way through, drops him for a loss of 10 yards. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Another try after the first down sack. Wentz. It's caught left side by Cooks. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. His second catch, and this one not nearly as electrifying as his first. And it'll bring up third down now. Wins. And Adams has it complete. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Able to convert on third and 14. A terrific play call. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 34. Throwing is Wentz. They'll run the screen with Carson. The first down screen pass, good for 5.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
They fake the give. Now Wentz. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked up by Avante Maddox.
There was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Well, that kind of hit will certainly fire up your team, both on the field and on the sideline. Tackles for lost yardage, they're always welcome.
On second and 11 now, Cousins. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Makes it third and 4.
Thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you'll have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it and pick up first downs.
And he'll get this one up to the 26.
Again, the ball carrier.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. He takes this for 3 to the 29. The Rams on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 4.
Brings up 3rd and 4.
From the gun, here's Cousins. Flushed out right. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline. But out of bounds, says the line judge, and it's going to bring up 4th down. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on 4th down.
Hey, we're good, we're good.
Desperation time. Cousins on 4th down. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet. A solid pickup of 5 and a very solid 4th down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. Here's Jacobs on 1st and 10. And he'll get 2, maybe 3 up near the 37.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7.
Once again, it's Jacobs.
Jacobs does a really nice job by then picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On third down, here comes Jacobs. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Henderson now on first and 10. And he takes this thing way down into Chicago territory. Big pickup of 38.
This has been a good drive so far. It's been the running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Henderson. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And it'll bring up a second and 14. They'll try to throw now. Cousins. Open man is Komet, the tight end. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5 yard line. A good pickup there. 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
Brings up third and
on third down. It's Jacobs. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. It's a 3 yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 2 yard line.
And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first time out. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2 minute warning. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Here's Jacobs. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. And his defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2 minute warning. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2 yard line. And he's going to get this back to the 3 yard line and no further. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal.
Brings up third and goal.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. For the lead, here's third and goal. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Darrell Henderson, his second touchdown on the season. And the Rams are going to jump back in front.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Yeah, part one is done, but now on the sideline, you already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
This will make it into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
at the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
Catch number 44 of on the year. It's a first down.
Bears, first down.
Back to throw. Wins. It's McCloud. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
First down, Chicago.
The left side throw complete to Adams. And he's got this down to the 35. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. He'll look to throw. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 12 more yards there, and another first down. Wentz to throw. And this is incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. That'll bring up second down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
And he's got the hook up to McCloud. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. Well, the Bears will use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play.
It's a never-say-never situation. But to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and 1 yard. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, 2nd and 1 yard from the 34. He's back to throw. That's complete right side to Kmet. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Here's Cousins. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. 7 yards, the pickup there. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock.
The 45-yard line.
to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Cousins to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
1st and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Now Cousins. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 41-yard line.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Jacobs now. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll move the chains. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. With 1 second to go, this to send us to overtime. And he's not able to come through. This is no good. And that is how this game comes to a close. Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline because you came here and you said you were not going to eat any of the media buffet. You made it to the end. You didn't consume a single calorie.
I appreciate that. What you missed is me going to the concession stand outside of your eyesight and getting it done that way. Look, I mean, they were serving the good stuff. I had to do it.
Oh, man, but you're svelte, in good shape, but yeah, you cheated a little bit. We'll let it slide.
I appreciate that. Always a pleasure to work with you.
So for Chicago, the win moves them up to 5-2 now on the year. And they'll return home next week to take on the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for L.A., the loss drops them back to 4-3 so far. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head down to Miami to take on the Dolphins. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gordon. This is the NFL on EA Sports. We'll be right back.